dear students, now we are back to our new session, geography. So all of you take out lesson number 3. Lesson number 3 is the earth major water bodies. We have completed it yesterday. I have published the question answers of lesson number 3-2. So let us go through the question answers. First question is what is an ocean? What is an ocean? That you will get from page number 25. Points to remember first one here. This is what ocean is: a vast area of water surrounding land and masses. That is what the answer number 1. And second question, name the oceans of the world. Which one is the largest? Name the oceans of the world and which one is the largest. We will get from page number Page number 20. Here you will get the four major oceans are the Pacific, Atlantic, the Indian and the Arctic. And this is what the four major oceans. Now let us go to next page, that Pacific Ocean. Let us see, Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean of the world. Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean of the world. And now next question, question number 3, what is a lake? What is a lake? Go to points to remember. Here, lake. A lake is a large body of water completely surrounded by land. What is a lake? Name one freshwater lake and one saltwater lake. That is what another question. One freshwater lake as well as one saltwater lake. Here you will get it. Page number 22. Freshwater. Among the freshwater lake, Lake Superior in the North America is the biggest one. One example of freshwater. Then is the Caspian Sea, is the saltwater lake one example. Okay, Caspian Sea as well as the Lake Superior. And now let us go to another. What is a lagoon? Lagoon you will get from points to remember. Lagoon. You will get from points to remember here. Lagoon is a lake that was a part of sea or another lake, but got separated from the main body of water. So what is it? Example we can see. So lagoon. Here it has gone. Lagoon, what is it? A lake was part of a sea or another lake. And already we have given to you Lake Chilica. That is what the answer of example. That is you will get from page number 22 here lake, this one Lake Chilka. Okay, and now you can go to next question, and that question is what are the three forms in which water exists on the earth? That you know, no need of showing anything, and you all knows the question. That is what all of you know. That is what ice, water, as well as gas, solid, liquid, and gas. And distinguish between the following: an ocean and a sea. An ocean and a sea, that from points to remember. First point, ocean is a vast area of water surrounding land masses. Sea, salt water masses smaller than an ocean. This is what? This one. And now let us see a river and a lake. That also from points to remember, lake. Fourth point, lake, a large body of water completely surrounded by land. River, last point, a large amount of water flowing a distance from higher to lower ground. Okay. And perennial and seasonal rivers. Next one. Perennial and seasonal rivers. That is a page number 22. Here, rivers that have water all the year round are called a perennial river. Okay, this is what the answer. Now go to next page. Rivers that do not have water all the year round are called a seasonal rivers. Okay, and this is what the answers. Now let us see long answer question. Why is the Caspian Sea considered to be the largest lake in the world? Caspian Sea, that you will get from page number 22. Page number 22 here. Seas that are completely enclosed by land are very large lake, hence Caspian Sea is the largest lake in the world. This is what the answer of first one, first long answer. And second long answer, why do the Arctic and Antarctic oceans remain frozen for many months of the year? Many months of the year. That is what? Arctic and Antarctic ocean remains frozen for many months of the year. That is page number 21. Arctic ocean, this side. There you will get on account of extremely low temperature, a large part of it remains frozen throughout the year. This is what the answer of this one. Second one. Now let us go to third question. Why are seasonal rivers so called? We'll have a some rivers, including the rivers of longest river, the Nile, these rivers are rise in very rainy regions. Rivers that do not have water all the year round are called seasonal rivers. This is what answer number C3. And now C4, importance of water. and there same page itself you will get a sum of one point from here. Water is essential for life, only that much. Then go to next side here. Water can absorb store more than most of other liquid from here. And you go to next page. Yeah, water bodies that are navigable for boat, ships, and help in transportation and trade. And here again you will get some more from here. Besides most of water support other organism that is useful to us. This also is one thing. And now let us go to last paragraph. We will have a last question's answer. Why is water pollution is harmful? Complete paragraph of this one. Okay, from here to here. And so dear students, have a nice day. Thank you. Take care.